LC Daniil Strayukovsky from Moscow, target therapy in early lung cancer. You know that lung cancer is a lot of many diseases. If we look at the target therapy and its place, it is very small. Around 20-25% of patients will have something to do with target therapy because there is some driver mutation that can be blocked, after which and that's what the target drugs are doing. And we may have a good effect. If we look at the number of patients with this earlier stages, they will be in minority. The majority of patients with driver mutations are advanced patients, and they receive target therapy, while local therapy for these patients is lower, but still it exists. And mainly these are patients with lung adenocarcinoma. Around 95-98% of these patients are lung adenocarcinoma, the others may be seen rather rarely. The structure of lung cancer changes as of today, more and more of adenocarcinomas. In our country, it prevails a little bit over squamous cell cancer connected with a change in cigarettes. Around 40% of these adenocarcinomas are not connected with smoking. On the other hand, the main success achieved was connected with the fact that adenocarcinoma was broken down to various subtypes, and in a great amount of patients, we managed to select one option or other of target therapy. But the diagnostics are now much more complicated, and the samples we take from these patients are of great importance, how to collect it, how to route it, and what to do with it in order to define approaches to therapy. There are many new nuances here, histological, molecular, genetic, etc. The situation is not simple at all. If we speak adenocarcinoma first and second stage, nobody argues the role of surgery. It is maximal here. In some cases, it may be also medicinal therapy or radiotherapy if the patient is functionally non-operable. If we speak about medicinal therapy in patients with driver mutations in earlier stages, here we only start seeing the role for patients with EGFR mutations. In other mutations, the role of target therapy is not clear due to the rarity of the disease itself and no clinical trials. Third stage, the approach here is individualized, connected with many circumstances, while 3B and 4th stage, first and foremost, different options of target therapy, but in 3rd and 4th stage, we can't exclude the role of surgery as one of the stages of cytoreduction operation that allows these patients to live with higher quality of life, longer, and some of them have chances to get cured, to my opinion. EGFR mutated adenocarcinoma of the lung, most often this is peripheral localization. Early stages are identified accidentally very often, but based on our experience, the patients of early stages have a bit worse prognosis in terms of progression. They progress more often compared to wild-type adenocarcinomas, hence adjuvant or neoadjuvant therapy is highly needed. What is the main goal of adjuvant therapy is to eliminate metastases whenever they are located. Adjuvant chemotherapy on average around 5%, a bit higher for 2B3A, a bit less for 2A3B. The first trial in terms of adjuvant target therapy, when there was no, when it was not clear in the design of trials who will need it, it was the study called Radiant. After adjuvant chemotherapy, patients with GFR expressing immunohistochemically, from the point of view of biology, it doesn't matter, but the adjuvant lovotinib was prescribed all platinum. When it turned out that it doesn't work, they found that there was some patients with the EGFR mutations. Fewer in the erlotinib group and more in the placebo group. Patients with mutations had a slightly better prognosis, but this didn't reflect on the overall survival. Another trial, select second phase, mono group received 60 patients received erlotinib adjuvant target therapy. Not bad survival curves, but we can't make a conclusion whether it is needed or not. And very similar curves for second and third stage. Not all the patients tolerate target erlotinib therapy in the adjuvant mode. The complications may be very serious, but 2 years progression-free survival is 88%. Not bad, not bad at all. The most discussable trial is Sitonga Oriental population, standard platinum chemotherapy was compared to gefitinib for the patients with mutated EGFR mutated adenocarcinoma of the lung. Target therapy certainly was much better. 27 months median PFS compared to 18. Delta was more than 10 months. And N2 group benefits the most. Statistically significant difference. Thus, we may say that with the EGFR mutation, gefitinib increases progression-free survival. Target therapy may be very efficient, and patients, the higher the stage, the more they benefit. And maybe we have to test early stages. The final conclusions may be drawn only when overall survival data are available. 2 years or less, there was a small trial that compared the fatinib. This trial was not balanced in terms of advanced stages, so we can't perceive it as a guide for action. It was shown that 2 years is better than 3 months. Maybe this is connected with biology, maybe with low potency of the low power of the trial and imbalance of groups. Meta-analysis was carried out of a EGFR-mutated adenocarcinoma of the lung. In this meta-analysis, we may conclude that there is use from neoadjuvant target therapy, both from the point of view of PFR and overall survival. In large groups, we may see this. Another meta-analysis performed by different authors, and we see that the neoadjuvant target therapy is beneficial, but there are lots of questions. Which drug to use better in terms of efficacy and tolerability? A mechanism of action may be similar, but different toxicity. The duration of adjuvant therapy is not clear, and the patients have to be selected. EGFR inhibitors as of today, taking the biology into account, do not cure patients, but delay the progression timelines. Survival without progression is increased. Optimal duration is not clear, and they are not always suitable for prevention. These are the trials performed as of today in this area, and I think that ADAURA will be a very interesting trial. Neoadjuvant therapy. Another interesting approach. It's early to use target therapy, early use of target therapy, then surgery, then analysis. Another colleagues from the East, erlotinib and chemotherapy 1.5 months both. There were many patients, but only 35 were randomized into each group. lots have been screened, but not very many randomized. You see how difficult it is to be enrolled in such trials. The trial was very well balanced, and what we see, the target therapy is more efficient, 54% compared to 34% of the response probability. The higher percent of patients received radical surgery, including R0, which is very important. And major pathological response comes onto stage here. In spite of the fact that target therapy lasted only for 42 days, but some of patients had very good response to it. This wasn't seen in case of chemotherapy with two cycles only. There's a probability of a good response, and it prevails among the patients who receive target therapy first and foremost. Survival curves, progression-free survival. There's a great difference, almost 10 months between the groups, and the trial was not large, women benefit more, and women with pronounced lung adenocarcinoma are the main population of the patients we see as of today in our routine clinical practice. Thus, we may say neoadjuvant therapy increases the incidence of response to therapy significantly. MPR, number of R0 resections, number of metastases in lymph nodes in case of M2, or objective response rate is much higher, but no data in terms of overall survival. Thus, we may conclude that the main information today in terms of the use of target therapy in early cases comes from EGFR mutation patients, ALK mutation, or the second group of driver mutations. The studies are going on. These are different biologically and clinically diseases, and we can't extrapolate the results. A risk of progression in patients with a EGFR mutation, to my opinion, is higher compared to wild type. And we have to take this into account when we think about what's to be done with these patients after surgeries. Adjuvant therapy decreases the risk of progression, but it is not clear whether it cures or not. On the whole, the disease is quite indolent. Maybe there won't be a sufficient time in taking into account the patients receive target therapy in progression. We probably won't see the difference in terms of overall survival, as is the case with rather indolent tumors. And neoadjuvant target therapy also has the right to exist, especially in patients with border-like disease and even fourth-stage oligometastatic disease after target therapy, I think, have a right to corrective surgery. That may eliminate the symptoms, because by eliminating the main tumor, we eliminate the main source of metastasis and mutation. Thank you. Danilo Львович, any questions? May I ask a question? If we speak about neoadjuvant target therapy, can't you expect the so-called outburst syndrome after the cancellation of target therapy after the surgery? For target therapy, we didn't see this on the whole, thanks God. There is a certain group of patients that start progressing on the background of target therapy very gradually. If target therapy is cancelled, the progression of the disease may accelerate. Again, there is an idea that the cancellation of target therapy leads to this outbreak. But we cancel target therapy for those patients who have more indolent, more aggressive course of the disease and switch to small cell. And leave target therapy when there is such very slow progression. Especially when chemotherapy is.